The state of Georgia has an extensive transit network that includes rural demand response service, van pools, fixed route and express buses, paratransit, streetcar, ferry, and heavy rail services. Transit is available in 123 counties across the state. Service is provided by more than 90 different transit systems throughout Georgia, including MARTA, which operates the nation's eighth busiest heavy rail network, and Chatham Area Transit, which operates the state's only public transit ferry service. Outside Metro Atlanta, nearly 80% of Georgia's population is served. Together, Georgia's transit systems provide more than 144 million passenger trips throughout the state each year, supporting economic development by connecting Georgians to jobs, healthcare, and educational opportunities daily.
Transit is an integral part of the economic development strategy for the state of Georgia. At the end of the day, we've got to be able to move people to and from work, to and from where they want to be.
Sometimes people don't realize how much transit ties into everything. If you look at APTA, they say for every $1 you spend or in public transit, you get $4 back in economic development return into the community.
Transportation also plays an important role to everyday people, you know, those who are trying to get to work, who are trying to get to shopping centers, who are trying to get to jobs in the service industry, and it also plays a role to students.
The Georgia Department of Transportation partners with local transit providers statewide to offer planning, financial, and educational training support. Developed in coordination with local governments, regional commissions, metropolitan planning organizations, and transit providers, GDOT Statewide Transit Plan charts the future direction of Georgia's transit programs through 2050. The plan documents public transit needs throughout the state and includes recommendations to improve access and mobility for all Georgians, with a particular focus on regional connectivity and rural communities.
The Statewide Transit Plan is a roadmap for transit in Georgia through the year 2050. It provides details on the needs across the state. We have reviewed about 200 local and regional plans that have been in place, put in place by local governments and others, to incorporate those planning efforts into our overarching plan that will address the needs across Georgia.
The Statewide Transit Plan's vision is to improve the quality of life and economic opportunities for all Georgians by supporting an innovative, connected, reliable, and accessible multimodal public transportation network. The plan assesses Georgia's demographic and economic conditions and identifies areas and populations with higher transit need, such as households without a vehicle, people with disabilities, and seniors. 37 counties currently do not have local transit service. In 33 counties, more than 10% of households do not have access to a vehicle. More than 18% of Georgians are 60 plus years old, with the senior population expected to more than double by 2050.
Transit is a very important part of our community. We have several areas that are predominantly elderly, and they rely on our transit system to get them to their appointments.
Since 2010, areas of the state served by transit have seen higher growth rates than communities without transit in terms of both population and job growth. In coordination with local partners, GDOT conducted a statewide public survey. Responses from nearly 3,000 Georgians representing transit riders and non-riders alike were crucial to understanding Georgia's transit needs. GDOT sought input from employers, community stakeholders, local leaders, and all of Georgia's transit providers to identify their specific needs for their systems and communities, including the need for expanded coverage and additional capacity, regional service, coordination with community partners, and leveraging technology and innovation.
We want to make better use of technology. For example, we're currently looking at the possibility of integrating microtransit into our community.
Transit is an absolute necessity to the people that we're serving, and not just the disability community, but transit is a necessity for everyone.
Currently, we have a lot of employees who live south of Hall County who want to get here, and then we have residents who live in Hall County that need to get to Gwinnett and Atlanta. So crossing county lines at this point is incredibly important.
Stakeholder input was also key to identifying opportunities and best practices throughout Georgia.
Our State Farm at Park Center campus here in Dunwoody is a direct connection to MARTA, We worked directly with MARTA and our developer to create a platform to allow easier accessibility for our employees to get to and from work.
As employers are looking at Georgia and they're looking at that workforce component of their decision, they're looking at transportation options because they know this younger generation is the workforce of the future, and those options are something that they want.
We're connecting people to medical, we're connecting people to faith-based, other health services, to and from their children's daycare, schools, and other opportunities that they may not have access to if transportation or transit services like this didn't exist.
The plan's quantitative needs assessment found that statewide up to 5.8 million additional rural transit trips are needed each year. Transit service needs are regional. Riders need to cross county and city lines to access jobs, health care, and educational opportunities. In urban areas, higher capacity and more frequent service is needed, as well as expanded geographic coverage. With this feedback in mind, future-focused recommendations were developed to meet the needs of providers and Georgians across the state. The plan outlines three overarching categories of recommendation: transit enhancements, transit expansion, and administrative tools and guidance. Specific recommendations include rural transit expansion to the 37 counties without local public transit, expanding capacity of existing systems to ensure that all rural trip needs are met, implementing higher frequency fixed route services where needed, meeting workforce and employer needs through extended service hours and more commuter routes, improving safety, system reliability, and on-time performance by deploying innovative technologies and strategies such as mobile fare payment options, transit signal priority, and dedicated transit lanes, planning and implementing regional and cross-jurisdictional systems, and enhancing coordination among transit providers, employers, healthcare, and educational providers. GDOT also incorporated local recommendations from urban transit plans, including the ATL Regional Transit Plan. There was also the recommendation for improving connections between local transit and inner city buses.
My vision for transit in 2050 would be, first of all, that it was accessible to all areas, including the most rural of areas, and that all of the transit had accessibility features.
You can read all about the statewide transit plan by visiting our website.